Now, when it comes to 3D printers, Monoprice have been at the front line of creating just about anything imaginable at a very affordable price tag. From as little as £90 for the Monoprice Mini to a mid-range price 3D printer like this. This is the Monoprice MP10, and at a current asking price, of which seems to be fluctuating around the £500 to £400 mark, it's a mid-range price point for what we can only hope to be a performance pack piece of kit, and luckily, you might be surprised. So let's unbox this guy and see exactly what you get in the box. I did get the EU edition, so it did come with an EU plug, but it wasn't a massive concern of mine as I have plenty of adapters lying around. So this isn't a pre-built machine, there is some assembly required, but when I say it's very dead simple, I'm not exaggerating. It's pretty much clip together and play. So some accessories are provided in a small toolbox, you get a filament rack, a fairly useless filament scraper to get your prints off the printing bed, USB, memory card, some wrenches for installation and maintenance, your screws for installation, power cord, and as always, a rather dead simple user manual. Let's jump straight into setup. It is dead simple as I said earlier, but it can be slightly fiddly, so just bear with it. Remove this part before installation. Then all we're going to do is grab your printing overhead, line it up and screw in your screws provided. Make sure this is done tightly as we don't want it to wobble when printing, as it will certainly affect the prints. Then we are going to remove the Z-axis screw rod from the base unit using the tools provided. Then insert the rod into the top section of the gantry. Once inserted, tighten the rod to ensure it's in place correctly. Now take the LCD screen and plug it into the rivet provided. Then use the screws and tools provided to place it into its designated place. Now we're going to add the filament spool holder to the back using the tools. Then add your spool holder grip. Now all you're left to do is plug up your cables. Place your power and filament cables on the back of the motherboard. The free cables should just simply slot into place. It is a little tricky, but don't be afraid to add a little bit of force. Then just add the power cable for the X motor into its designated slot as well. And that's honestly it. Plug it in and you should be good to go. It's always wise to calibrate the system first, and thankfully Monoprice have made this portion of the process so much simpler. With the auto bed leveling feature, inside we are rocking a bed leveling sensor which works very well at detecting the differences in the bed, which allows you to set an accurate Z offset to make sure the first print level is secure and adhered to the printing bed. What's also very nice about this printer is you have a removable heated and flexible printing bed. At 300 by 300 mm, there is plenty of room to print some really good quality prints. And the magnetic platform makes the process of cleaning and removing the bed itself very simple. The extruder is also magnetic, so if it comes to having to replace or change the extruder system, you can do this with ease and without the headache of fiddly screws and fittings. This also has resume print functionality, meaning in the unfortunate result of a power outage to the printer, it will remember its printing point, and if your filament runs out, the machine is equipped with a filament sensor that will automatically pause the print as well. So two great features there. Prints do come out really nice on this system, and that might come down to its dual wide gantry, which provides a stable base for printing and minimises most of the wobble that cheaper units may produce. The cat that's provided on the file SD card has a really nice print, and it does test the abilities of the printer overall. If you are using Cura, you will need to add a correct starting G-code and the information, and I'll link all that in the description below. But the user manual does contain all the individual information and settings you need to get the perfect profile for printing. The printing process is not the fastest of printers on the market, but it is precise and accurate. Layers on the print seem to come out really nice and overall very clean looking. I mean, it's to be expected for a mid-range printer, but when you start pushing its larger printing bed size to print more complex design, even then the printer is quite shockingly surprising. It deals with the printing demands very well, and after 3 to 4 prints, I haven't really had any issues with failed prints or over-extrusion. But that does come down to making sure the settings are correct. Overall, if you're on the market for a mid-range 3D printer that can deliver some very impressive prints, then I really can't recommend the MP10 any more than the words I've already said. Is it the best printer on the market for this price point? I highly doubt it. But from my experience, it delivers everything I'd expect from what I'd be asking for in terms of the price. Take a look at this bad guy in the description, let me know what you think, and as always, till next time.